everybody, and welcome to my kitchen, because today I have my own cooking show. So I watch a lot of Food Network, and I would love to have my own cooking show. However, I am better at the eating part than the cooking part. So today I'm cooking something that I have not made in almost 10 years. Okay, so rewind, back up. So when I was 16, I went to Spain, France, and Italy. And I was with People to People, the student ambassador group, and because we were student ambassadors, it was more like a learning-based type trip. So before we left, we had to do some sort of project. You could do a paper, you could do a poster board, or you could do a dish from one of the countries that we were visiting. So of course, duh, I picked to make a dish, and I chose a gnocchi! And I'm probably not even saying it right, but I don't care, I'm American. So I made a gnocchi, and I loved it. It wasn't really easy to make, but it was really easy to follow the recipe to make it. So I decided that today I'm going to bring you guys into my kitchen and we are going to make a gnocchi together. So I'm kind of hoping that this doesn't end in a disaster, but if it does, you guys get to see it and make fun of me for it. So we're making gnocchi and I have got my potatoes boiling. The recipe calls for 4 large-ish potatoes, so I don't really know what large-ish looks like. Medium, I guess. So I've got 4 large-ish potatoes in the pot. So you're supposed to boil them until they're soft but not falling apart. Not like you were going to make mashed potatoes, because later we're going to grate them, so they can't be falling apart. They need to kind of still hold their shape. Then I've got 2.5 cups of flour. I've got 2 eggs in this bowl. And I've kind of lightly floured this bowl already because this bowl is where the potatoes are gonna go and I don't want them to stick to the bowl. Okay, so the potatoes have been boiling for about 10 minutes and they're not supposed to be soft like mashed potatoes. And this one's kind of falling apart, so I think they're ready for draining? I guess we're gonna find out. But I think I'm gonna drain them anyway and just see how it turns out. So I just drained the potatoes. They are supposed to cool enough for me to touch them because then we get to grate them. So now the potatoes have cooled enough to where I can touch them. So now I'm going to grate them. So now I'm going to take my grated potatoes and I'm going to mix them with the flour and the eggs to make a dough. Does not look like what the recipe says it's supposed to look like. So now I'm just supposed to roll the dough out on a floured surface, and I'm just going to use my countertop, which I have washed prior to starting this. All right, and I'm just supposed to knead it until it starts to get more elasticity. So it's getting doughier the more I've added more flour, and it's getting more dough-like, but I still don't think it's pasta dough consistency. I suppose because this is potatoes, maybe that's why, but it's okay. Okay, so to be honest, the dough doesn't really look like dough. I definitely think I failed somewhere. I have no idea what happened. I did exactly what the recipe says, But we're gonna try and keep going and making it anyway. I think the potatoes are like grated a little bit too coarse. And I don't know if that's maybe because I didn't actually let them boil long enough or if I just used the wrong side of the grater. I don't know. Don't know what happened. I'm gonna try and see if I can, you know, cook these anyway and see what happens. So I just tried rolling them into these little dough balls so that I could cook them. And I think that is what happened. I think that my potatoes were still just not boiled enough because I can see the little pieces of potato in here and I don't think I'm supposed to. I hope they taste okay. It's just a potato thing. So I've just put all of my dough balls in the pot of boiling water and I'm just gonna wait until they float to the top and then I'm just gonna take them out and I'm going to toss them with some tomato sauce. This is just the Classico tomato and basil. No, I did not make my own tomato sauce because if this is a fail, I can't imagine what a fail the tomato sauce would be. Ooh, there's a couple floating. Hopefully they cooked okay. All right, so I've got some here. They're done. I've tossed them with the tomato sauce. So now we're going to try them. All right, the inside looks okay. Inside looks a little bit cooked. A little bit cooked. They actually don't taste that bad. I'm kind of surprised. I thought they'd be a little bit weird. Okay, so the texture is a little bit weird because you've got these like potato chunks in them almost, but they don't taste as bad as I thought they would. That's gonna be the name of my cooking show, by the way. Not as bad as I thought it would taste. So I think I wanna make this a more regular thing where I like try recipes that I've never made before from, you know, other countries, or I think I definitely wanna try beignets. If you like this video and want to see me screw up more recipes, then give this video a thumbs up. If there's anything that you guys suggest I should try and make and hopefully not fail at, you can leave those in the comments below. And if you actually have recipes, that would be great. Although clearly I had a recipe for this and it still failed. But whatever, it's fine. I think we're only gonna call this a half fail because it tastes okay. It just looks a little weird and the dough is a little weird. Thank you guys so much for watching and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.